But yeah, like, I don't know if I've said this on stream before. I know I've said this, like, in servers. But, like, the main thing that motivated me to do, like, content creation and, like, double down on it and stuff was literally I just want money to, like, go on these flights. Like, basically, if I spend money on, like, almost nothing else, I can afford to go on a flight, like, once a month if I can get the girl to host. But if I also have to factor in hotels, you know, like, unironically, 3 days at a hotel is more expensive than a flight. I've flown out 6 different times for trans women. And the second time I flew out, I got topped by a Venezuelan trans woman who lived in Canada. She was born in Canada, and she had a 7.5-inch penis, and it was uncircumcised. That was based. And afterwards, I kind of just played Fallout 1 and 2. And I've flown out to Los Angeles, Hollywood, twice, because I just saw that there were, like, a lot of attractive trans women there on Tamie. And so the first time I flew out, I didn't even have a solid plan, right? I had, like, kind of, like, some plan to meet up with some chick, but I really felt like she was gonna flake. So I just decided, you know, I was really horny. Like, really horny. I hadn't been with anyone in, like, 4 months. And so, like, what I did was I just impulsively flew out there. Because I knew that there were a lot of attractive trans women who topped men, who lived in Los Angeles for some reason. Los Angeles just had a ton of them. I didn't know it was, like, Hollywood, more specifically, like, West Hollywood. But yeah, I just flew out, and I didn't even plan the trip. So the first time I flew out to Hollywood, I flew in at, like, the flight left at, like, 10:30. The plane landed at, like, almost midnight. I didn't fly into L.A., I flew into Ontario, California, which is a suburb of LA, and I had to walk all the way to Upland Station. And I also didn't book a hotel that night. I was, like, really concerned about finances. So I didn't book a hotel that night. I didn't think I would need to. I thought you could just book a hotel the day you did that. I was just too neurotic to, like, book the hotel. I was stressing out about it too much. So I didn't. And you can't, you have to book in advance. So, like, I couldn't stay the night at a hotel. So I just walked to the train station and I took the 4:30 a.m. bus into LA. And, and when I was waiting at the station, there was just this lady. She was, like, 60 years old or something. She was drunk off her ass. She was partying with friends. And she just decided to, like, take the train into LA from Upland. At, like, 4:30 in the morning. So that was, like, my introduction to Los Angeles. Was just talking to some, like, drunk 60-year-old woman on rollerblades. She fell down. She was rollerblading at, like, at 3 o'clock in the morning. To be fair, it was probably more like, 4, 3:30. I don't think she rollerbladed very far to get to the train station, but yeah. I just took the train into Los Angeles, and then I went to Hollywood, and I was, like, riding a rental bike through the streets of LA at, like, 6 o'clock in the morning, 6:30 in the morning, because that was when I got there, and it was actually kind of nice because there wasn't that much traffic then, and I was, like, so tired because I didn't sleep, so I just stayed at this cafe. I walked around Hollywood Boulevard. I rode around there. I rode my bike up, like, the Hollywood Hills. And, after that, I just chilled at this cafe. I stayed in, like, the back of the cafe. Because a lot of places there have, like, anti-homeless measures. And, I just didn't want to get on their bad sides or anything. So I just, like, hid in the back room, and I was shaving and, like, brushing my teeth in their rooms. You know, getting ready to, like, you know, maybe meet up with this girl. And while I was there, I just swiped on Tamie because, you know, I was there. And, I just, like, chatted up, like, a bunch of trans women on Tamie in Hollywood. And, there was one girl who I was talking to there, we just clicked really well. Like, she sent me, like, she sent voice messages. Those were her things when she was flirting. And, it turns out that she actually wasn't trans. She was intersex, but not trans. But she had an inch piece. And, so, you know, I just, yeah. I just bummed around Hollywood some more and, like, Chinatown in L.A. And when I was there, so the entire trip, the only things that I ate were, I ate trail mix. So I ate raisins, dark chocolate, walnuts. That was my trail mix. And then I ate, like, some bananas that I got in Chinatown. And also some tofu that I got in Chinatown. So I ate, bananas, soy, walnuts, and chocolate. Those were, the four things that I ate that entire trip. And I was there for, like, 3, maybe 4 days. And, yeah. Oh, yeah, and also, one crazy thing is I ended up getting a hotel in Ontario, not in Los Angeles. So, like... The other, like, 2 days I was there. This is dumb, but the other 2 days I was there, I was actually riding the bus into LA from Ontario and back every single day. It was the stupidest shit ever. And it sucked because, you know, I could have spent the night with her, like... you know, the day I had to go back, my return flight was at 5:30 in the morning. I picked the worst times to fly out, and I was flying Spirit Airlines for the first time. Like, prior to then, I was only doing, like, Frontier because I had heard bad things about, like, Spirit and them having a tendency to cancel flights, but I've flown Spirit a few times. They haven't canceled flights on me. I've been fine. Oh, right, but, like, when it comes to, like, that trip to L.A., I don't know, that was just, that was, like, there were some times when I was loving it, there were some times where I was just really high-strung, but, yeah, like, when I was flirting with that girl in that, in that cafe, you know, the cafe had, like, so it had an upstairs, and it had a back room with, like, a ton of couches, and I was just, like, laying there, you know, like, dicking around on, like, my computer and stuff, you know, just, like, that, I don't know, that was just awesome. Like, my dick was, like, leaking pre-cum the whole time. I was that horny. Like, so I'm not gonna lie. I've had, like, booty calls. There's been, like, a few booty calls from trans women, locally. And every single time, I have pretty much just, like, turned them down. There was one time I turned a girl down and I just flirted with this other girl who was, like, you know, 2,000 miles away instead. Because, like, I wasn't comfortable with that. I didn't want to, like, drive out. Like, I have access to a family car. I could go there, but I didn't want to drive out at, like, you know, I don't know. I kind of feel insulted by booty calls. Like, I'm just supposed to drop everything to go fuck you. I hardly even know you. Fuck off, bitch. But yeah, you know, like, I would rather chat up some girl who lives, like, 2,000 miles away and has Riz, and then I'd have to pay, like, $300 to go see. And then I'd pay the $300. I would rather pay the $300 than just drive out for someone local and pay, like, you know, maybe $15 maximum in gas. I don't know, the way I see it, like, I've met some people who are like, oh my god, I would never fly out for someone. Or, like, I can't see myself ever doing that, and I don't get that. I don't understand that. It doesn't make sense to me. Because the thing is, like, I don't know, I think if you like someone enough, like, it should just... Like, do you even like them if you're not willing to fly out? I get it if you're, like, super poor.
But I enjoy driving.
Yeah. But I get it if you're, like, super poor. Oh, yeah, I would drive if I liked someone enough, too. But, To be honest, I don't like driving. I hate driving. I unironically, I would rather spend like 2 hours, 30 minutes on a bus, and then another like hour on a train, and then 4 hours on a plane, and then 2 hours walking to another train station, and then 1 hour on that train, and then another like 30 to 45 minutes on a bus, then drive. Driving sucks. Cause if you're on like a bus or a train, like sure there might be some homeless people there, and you know those people can be icky, but it's a passive activity. You can do other things. You can like fuck around on social media. You could bring your Game Boy with you, and you could replay Mega Man Zero 3 for like the 50th time. You could read a book. You could write a script for a video. You could even edit a video on your laptop or even on your phone. You could edit porn on your phone while on the train to go visit someone. You could get so much work done because, like, when you're at home, you know, you tend to be, like, more prone to distractions and stuff. And, yeah, like, you could do so much when you're on the bus or the train. Like, there may be homeless people, and sometimes, like, subways. The subways in LA especially smell like hobo piss. Public transportation is fine, even in, like, shitty areas. Like, as long as there's not some crazy druggy screaming at, like, his paralysis demons, you're fine. You're fine.
Not even sleep paralysis demons, just paralysis.
Yeah. But, like, you're fine, pretty much. Like, you know? Still a better experience than having to drive. But, yeah, like, I don't know if I've said this on stream before. I know I've said this, like, in servers. But, like, the main thing that motivated me to do, like, content creation and, like, double down on it and stuff was literally I just want money to, like, go on these flights. Like, basically, if I spend money on, like, almost nothing else, I can afford to go on a flight, like, once a month if I can get the girl to host. But if I also have to factor in hotels, you know, like, one night at a hotel can be, like, $150, you know? Like, unironically, 3 days at a hotel is more expensive than a flight. It's crazy. But yeah, you know, like, I don't know, I just think it's exciting to go fly out to see someone. And it's not like I don't, so like, if a woman's local, I will try and go see her, you know, like, I've done that before, I've gone on local dates, but like, it's just more exciting to fly out for me. I mean, maybe not if I'm going to some shithole, which is why, like, I haven't flown out to, like, a rural area. Because, like, icky, gross, the rural area. Like, not necessarily, they're not a terrible place to live if you, want to drive, but, like, I don't want to, like, visit a farm in Kentucky. That doesn't interest me.
Yo, Kentucky has so much cool fucking places to drive at, though. Holy shit.
Oh.
Like, Louisville, Kentucky? Oh. I love that place. Even if it is really fucking goofy.
Hmm.
Maybe I just know too many people from Louisville.
Ah, dude. I wish I could stay in the mines, but I can't. Gotta go. Oh, speaking
Gotta
of which...
Bless.
A Superman theme. I drink coffee. I passed out inside of the house. So it's cool.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I took the one, I took like the first step in and I passed out. Chances for gems to appear in pairs versus one or oh yeah.
Gems did you really to, take that?
No, gems to appear in pairs is like worthless. Level okay, 5 combat, cool. A scout versus fighter. Critical strike.
I like
you like scout?